This butchery demonstration video has been developed by AHDB Beef and Lamb as part of their meat education program, an accessible and free to use educational resource. Full details of the program can be viewed at the end of the video.
For the cuts we're now going to produce, we need a 6-bone 4-quarter of lamb. And we are going to remove the neck bones and rib cage with the sheet boning method. We need to make sure that we don't cut in underlying muscles. And once we remove the neck and rib bones, we can now also remove the yellow gristle lying on the neck. The breast tip is also removed in line with the knuckle. And the knuckle is removed by cutting and sawing to the humerus bone in a straight line. And as you can see, we are now removing the neck fillet and associated muscles by following the natural seams. And this, by following the natural seams, it will bring us back onto the blade bone, which we follow, the tip of the blade bone. And as you can see, the whole muscle block rolls out fairly easily. Once we come to the end here, we can cut right through and separate two muscle blocks. Now the main shoulder block, which is still bone in, is now trimmed of all excess fat and gristle. It is very important to remove the big fat pockets, as you can see here. And also this blood vein. Now we turn the muscle block over and remove all excess fat, especially the fat layer on the outside, which is on the other side of the blade bone. That needs to be trimmed off, making sure we don't leave too much lean meat on the fat. We only remove fat, not meat. Now we can score the muscle block at regular intervals. And this is now the rustic lamb shoulder, which would be ideal for a roasting joint. The lamb Henrys are produced from the rustic lamb shoulder joint. We cut the blade bone section into two equal portions, as we do in the humerus bone section into two equal portions. This will now produce 4 equal portions out of the rustic lamb shoulder joint. These joints are ideal for slow roasting. For the lamb ribeye joint, we utilize the neck fillet and associated muscles, which we have trimmed of all excess fat, and the neck section is also removed. We roll the joint and secure that with little roasting band at regular intervals. And once we've done that, we square the joint on both sides, leaving us with a nice lamb ribeye joint. And to summarize, the 4-quarter has produced now the rustic lamb shoulder, the lamb Henry's lamb ribeye joint, and the knuckle.
AHDB Beef and Lamb has launched the Meat Education Program, an accessible and free-to-use web-based educational resource for the whole of the meat industry. It aims to help you to enhance both your knowledge and understanding and provide you with certification. It is targeted at the whole of the meat supply chain, including learn how to debone and break down beef and lamb carcasses into primal cuts, and how to cut primal muscles into retail and food service cuts. Learn how to produce cuts that deliver a more tender and consistent eating quality. Learn how to recognize different beef and lamb cuts and understand the best cooking methods for each. Learn about new cuts and how to identify opportunities for these products on menus. Learn about cattle and sheep production, what the different breeds are used for, and the names used to describe different types of animals. Learn about carcass classification and the factors that can affect meat quality. Understand the difference between service and hospitality and learn how to read your customers. Learn about the different meat cuts, specifications, and what they're used for. Learn about the meat industry in general, the various stages of the supply chain, and understand the different terminology used. Learn about different cuts of meat, where they come from, and their use in the different industry sectors. At the heart of the Meat Education Program is an innovative web-based platform which can be accessed via AHDB Beef and Lamb's trade website. Online assessment and certification are available free of charge for the theory modules. The three practical beef and lamb modules will be assessed at the learner's place of work by highly experienced butchery professionals. There are 16 theory and practical modules in the Meat Education Program, and each is supported by must-read study materials, free to download, that have been produced to help learners achieve optimum results. You can track your own progress online while you are logged in. The website will highlight which assessments have been taken, results, and any certificates that have been achieved. To register to start using the Meat Education Program, or for further information, visit www.qsmbeefandlamb.co.uk/MEP.